Hello friends, welcome to Rearrangement Redefined, brought to you by Mahendra Guru, the Brahmaster of Success. You wanted a video on rearrangement and here it is. So let's just start with the points that you should always know regarding rearrangement. The first point is it contains 6 to 8 sentences in a jumbled form. So they're going to be in a jumbled form and you are actually needed to arrange them. That's mentioned in the second one as well. Candidates need to read and arrange the sentences in the correct form. So actually it's you who have to arrange them in the correct form. Now the third point over here is there's usually a single rearrangement exercise that contains 5 marks. So actually in examination these days, there's only a single rearrangement exercise that actually it contains 5 marks and you'll have to get that. So the last point over here is financial or social or environmental story based rearrangement are given in the examination. So these days the topics that are there in the rearrangement are actually based on financial or social, environmental or story based topics. Now let's have a look at the points to remember. See, here are the few points to remember regarding the rearrangement. The first is attempt rearrangement of sentences at last. This is actually something that I've been telling you from a long time. Whenever it comes to rearrangement sentences, always attempt it at last. The next point is read all the sentences patiently and try to understand them while reading. You'll have to be patient so that you can concentrate when you are actually reading the sentences for rearrangement of sentences. That's why read all the sentences patiently with concentration and then try to understand them while reading. So here's the next point. It is search for the sentences that contains. Actually, search the sentence that contains the subject. That will be there. Generally, the subject is a noun. And after having a look through all the sentences, you should actually get for the sentence. Go for the sentence that actually contains the verb or rather the subject in your points. That's going to be a noun. Now here's the next point. It's make logical pairs and align them at last. See, these days you get 6 sentences or 7 sentence rearrangement or 8 sentences in a rearrangement. So what you should do is you should actually make logical pairs and then align them at last. The last point over here is practice, because practice makes a man perfect. Now let's have a look at most of the points to remember. So here are the points to remember, a few more of them. Actually, 2 of them, and they are really important. These are the basic requirements for rearrangement sentences. Now, why are these required? Because see, just like Sudoku and just like crossword puzzle, rearrangement is also actually a brainy game and you have to play with your brain. Now, what's the requirement besides these? If your grammar is good, if your vocabulary is good, as well as if your current awareness is good, you can definitely play the game of rearrangement of sentences. Here are some basic qualities that are required here. The first quality is reading skill. Now, when you develop reading skill, actually you start visualizing the next sentence of a particular article, or you start visualizing the next sentence that's required in a rearrangement. And how you can do that? You can only do that through practice and through reading a lot of articles that we publish for you on Mahendra Guru. So when you keep on reading them, regularly, definitely your reading skills improves and you are actually, not only you become knowledgeable, you actually develop the skill of reading, in which you only read one sentence or two and then you will start visualizing what's the next sentence. Now, next one over here is cognitive ability. What's cognitive ability? It's nothing but the ability to judge the future based on your past experience. It's nothing regarding some astronomy or something, but just the ability to judge the future regarding a particular thing based on your past experience. Now, just tell me one thing. Don't you know the footsteps of your parents? I suppose you know the sound of that, right? And that's why whenever your father or your mother comes toward you, even though they are not in your visual range, you cannot see them, but still you know that your father or mother is coming towards you. In the same way, I suppose many of you actually use vehicles, most of you would be using two-wheeler vehicles. So don't you know the sound of the two-wheeler vehicle that you use? Of course you know. Even if you are not able to see it, you can just hear the sound of the engine of your two-wheeler and you can say, that is my two-wheeler, right? Actually, this is just the magic of cognitive ability of your brain. If you can do these two things, definitely your brain has got cognitive ability and definitely you can get rearrangement of sentences as well. Now, why am I saying so? See, I don't think you would have done any effort in actually, in gaining the knowledge of the footstep of your parent, I suppose you wouldn't have made any effort in gaining the knowledge of the sound of your engine, but your brain heard that these sounds again and again and again, processed it and saved it, and that's why you are able to guess who is coming towards you, is it your father, is it mother, or what's the sound of your engine. actually this is nothing but the magic of your brain, brain's cognitive ability that you develop by practicing and hearing the sound again and again. In the same way, when you practice rearrangements again and again, when you read a lot of articles, your brain develops cognitive ability towards rearrangement of sentences as well. And this not only helps you in rearrangement, but also helps you in reading comprehension and closest as well. Now let's move forward. Let's go for the parts of the rearrangement. See, generally a rearrangement can be of 6 to 8 sentences. But there are mainly 6 parts of a rearrangement. In the same way, just in the same way, like all of our bodies have got 206 bones, but we are only able to see the 6-7 main parts of the body. Now, here are the things. See, the first one over here is subject. That's the first part. The second is qualifier of the subject. The third is verb. The fourth is qualifier of verb. The fifth is object. And the sixth is qualifier of object. Now, you have to repeat with me. The first part is the part of the object, the second part is the qualifier of subject, the third is part of verb, the fourth is qualifier of verb, the fifth is the object, and the sixth is qualifier of object. Now let's have a look at the first part. See, here's the first part is the part of the subject, and what is it? What does it contain? It is the easiest part to identify usually, but the SBI or IBPS can take you for a ride if you let your guard down. In this part, the subject gets introduced, which can be a fact, a topic, or an extremely rare case, a famous person. See, the part of the subject introduces you to the rearrangement, and in most of the cases, it's going to be a noun. In fact, in 95% of the cases, it's going to be a noun. Definitely, in fact, I suppose you also know about this thing that the pronouns and the connecting adverbs like nevertheless or however do not start the rearrangement in 95% of the cases. There's only a 5% minor case when a pronoun or a rearrangement may start the a pronoun or a connecting adverb may start a rearrangement. There are only 5% chances of this. When that happens, the subject is actually mentioned just after this connecting adverb or pronoun, or it may be mentioned any place after the word. But no one thing, in 95% of the cases, the subject of a rearrangement is actually a noun. Now, here's an example for you, and you have to tell me what's the subject over here, and did this particular sentence start with a pronoun or connecting adverb? So here's the sentence. It is, in the present financial year, inflation has become a menace for the government of India. In the present financial year, inflation has become a menace for the government of India. And tell me one thing. Did this sentence start with a pronoun? No. Did the sentence start with a connecting adverb? Like nevertheless or however? No. It started with a preposition. And in the 95% of the cases, the vast majority is going to be in this way only. In the present financial year, inflation has become a menace for the government of India. What's the subject here? Tell me that. Inflation. Yes, it's the subject of the sentence. Why? Because in this sentence, we are getting introduced to the problem of inflation that has been identified as a menace for the government of India. Let's have a look at the next part. See, here's the qualifier of subject for you. This part adds more information regarding the subject in the sense of identity. Sometimes it completes the part of the subject. For example, it has become a failure for the government as well as the RBI. That's written over here. See, the qualifier of subject adds more information regarding the subject, primarily regarding the identity of the subject. It helps you in identifying the subject in a better way. And it can also complete in some cases the part of the subject. So here's an example for you. It has become a failure for the government as well as the RBI. Now, what do you think? What is being referred as it over here? Now, let's go back a bit. See, here's the previous sentence. In the financial year, inflation has become a menace for the government of India. The subject was inflation. And the next part qualifier says, it has become a failure for the government as well as the RBI. So what is this it regarding? Inflation. Yes. Now, next part over here, it's going to be a part of the verb. Now, what's there? This part shows the action of the subject. It actually shows what the subject did directly or indirectly, or what was the change in the circumstances due to subject's action in a direct or an indirect way. So here's a sentence that is example for you. The wholesale price index of goods has been raised due to inflation, which has caused price rise in the market. So the wholesale price index of goods has been raised due to inflation, which has caused a price rise in the market. Now you can see what the verb did. Now, actually over here, the verb is the increase in the wholesale price index. You can say the WPI of goods got increased here. Because of which? Because due to of inflation. The subject increased the prices over here, that mentioned in the part of the verb. Now let's have a look at the next part. See, here's the next part is going to be the qualifier of verb. Now what's the end qualifier of verb? It adds more information regarding the action of the subject. So the qualifier adds more information regarding what? Regarding the action of the subject. And it's mentioned over here, it is the rise in price. The rise in prices has caused an unrest in the financially unstable middle and lower class families of the economy. So the rise in prices, actually what happened? Rise in prices what? Is actually, this part is adding more information regarding the action of the subject that was mentioned in the previous sentence. So the rise in prices has caused an unrest in the financially unstable middle and lower class families of the economies. So this is what? This is just adding more information regarding the WPI increase due to inflation. Now let's have a look at the next part. I suppose you were able to get it till now. Next part over here is, this part shows the affected entity in the rearrangement due to the subject. See, definitely part of the object is going to be concerned with the one with the affected party. So that what does that? It shows the condition of the affected party which got affected due to the action of the subject. So over here is an example for you. The common man is the ultimate loser because he loses both his savings and purchasing power due to inflation. The common man is the ultimate loser because he loses both the savings and purchasing power due to inflation. In this part, now what's the object over here? It's the common man. Why? Because he is getting affected as he is losing his savings and purchasing power due to the subject. So the subject is affecting the object, and this is the condition of the object that is actually shown in the part of the object. Now these are the five parts. Let's have a look at the last part. See, here's the last part. It's called the qualifier of the object. In this part, we see the summary or the reaction of the object in the rearrangement. So actually the summary is given or the reaction of the object is given in the qualifier of the object. Let's have a look at this example. It is, the government, the RBI and the common man need to work together to counter the mercurial effects of inflation. The government, the RBI and the common man need to work together to counter the mercurial effects of inflation. So we have given the summary over here of this particular rearrangement. Now let's club all these examples together and let's see whether it forms a paragraph or not. So let's go back. Now here's the first example for you. It is, in the present financial year, inflation has become a menace for the government of India. Now the next sentence is, it has become a failure for the government as well as the RBI. The wholesale price index of goods has been increased due to, has been raised due to inflation, which has caused a price rise in the market. The rise in prices has caused an unrest in the financially unstable middle and lower class families of the economy. The common man is the ultimate loser because he loses both his savings and purchasing power due to inflation. The government, the RBI and the common man need to work together to counter the mercurial effects of inflation. So I suppose you were also able to see that this whole, what do you say, when we clubbed all these examples together, it seemed like a proper paragraph. And that's what you have to do after arranging the rearrangement sentences in the exercise of rearrangement of sentences. Now there's also a last minute tip for you, and that is, this is a special tip. A short way of improving rearrangements is by reading the first and the third para of a three para article after skipping the second para. So a short way of improving rearrangement is after the reading the first and third para of a three para article after skipping the second para. And we have also tell you something over here. After you have read the first and third para of an article, try to pen down the facts in the second para on your own. Now the last point over here is, the higher the accuracy of the facts, the better you get in rearrangement. So I'll give you in a short way as well. When you get a three para article, what you should do, you should read the first and third para and you should skip the second para. Then after you have read the first and third para, just note down what you think was there in the second para. Higher the accuracy matches, higher the accuracy gets, the better you get in your rearrangement of sentences. Now practice a lot of STs that we give you. In that way, you'll actually improve in your rearrangement of sentences. So that was all in our discussion of particular tips and tricks. We hope that it was actually beneficial for you, and you will learn it and you will like it as well. Thank you. Your success is our success.